What's going on, everybody? We're going to make this quick. I'm not going to do any commentary on this. I did on the last one, but I've had to go check in on our son two or three times. He's still breathing, still doing good. It's just weird that he's been sleeping since like 11. So it's been about 3 hours, 3.5. So I'm expecting him to wake up anytime soon and cry. So what we're going to do is just going to go right ahead into this game here. There's, like I said, no commentary. But we're going to go into this game and hopefully get a dub. I apologize if this game goes past the 1 hour mark. And there is any moments where it's just standing around. So if that is the case, you may not see this video being uploaded. But again, I don't have software or anything, but I will try to speed this game up as fast as I can. So guys, enjoy. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.
As we're off in week 9. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And he'll maybe get it back to the 25 here on the first play, but no more than that. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, he can't hold them.
The numbers for Andrews last week, 6 catches, 86 yards.
And they think they have a matchup advantage in this one. They're going to try and find some space for him to work and make sure he touches the football.
First carry now for Gus Edwards. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Now it's Jackson. And that is incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
And taken right at the 35. 47-yard punt, a return of 4. And it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
And I think if you ask most folks to give you their first half MVP, very likely they're going to say it's this man right here, the NFL's leader in touchdown passes. To this point in the season, still 2 months to go. But if he can keep going to the pace he's at, this is going to be a dangerous team come January, and he can very well walk away with the MVP.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So in Raven territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 36. That'll be caught by Bobo. Well, this defense for the Ravens, they were excellent a week ago in the victory over Arizona.
Well, let's face it, when you hold someone to just 6 points in a game, the feeling that you have among your team is that you're not going to lose very many of those. That's the way to get it done.
On the slant, here's Smith and Jigba. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down. So, Charles, you know, offensively, this group really playing at a high level. 7-0. And we're still a long ways from discussing a potential unbeaten season, I think. But to use a golf expression, no blemishes on the card, at least to this point.
Yeah, unlike my teenage years where there were blemishes everywhere and the dermatologist was on speed dial. But I do think that they're going to have to start answering questions about this start.
Here's a diving catch right side. He finds Smith and Jigba in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. A great effort there, laying himself out in the end zone. And the Seahawks are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. And after the
the touchdown. Here's Myers to boot it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw complete there to Bateman. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 13 yards on his first catch. It's a first down as well. Here's Jackson to throw. He'll find Bateman once more. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Given back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Off the play fake to Dobbins. Here's Jackson. Pass the 20. And all the way in for the Ravens touchdown. Nelson Agholor. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from drawing level. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And we are tied at 7. Just a 4-play drive that time. And it was capped by the touchdown pass to Nelson Agholor. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25. Actually, the 26 officially. So a net gain of 1 there. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Hey, look at this Baltimore defense. And they find themselves just outside the top 10 in the league against the pass, currently bringing up the number 11 spot.
And the easy thought process is that stopping the run is the least of their problems because they're facing the number one passing team in the NFL. But if they don't stop the run as well, then that just opens up the passing game even more. They've got to do both.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. He'll look to throw. And complete to Smith and Jigba. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. They'll look to throw again. Over the middle, finding Smith and Jigba. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 22-yard line. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Then their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Outright to Smith and Jigba. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down. They'll look to throw here. This will be caught at about the 6. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake, third down. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He finds Smith and Jigba in the end zone for the Seahawks touchdown. A great play there with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. Myers connects on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Seahawk football here to start quarter number two. As they've got it as we resume action. Here's Myers now to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Ravens ready to take over. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And they'll begin by running the option. And now off to the races, down the right side. Inside the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson, 75 yards. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. Tucker with the extra point. And we are tied at 14. Shortest drives you've ever seen. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Jackson, Smith, and Jigba, and his offense ready to go once more here. Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but his shredding defense is getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw here. Smith and Jigba with the grab. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
2 touchdowns for him already in this first half. This one good for a first down. They'll set up to throw. And he's got Smith and Jigba. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He finds Smith and Jigba. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll make it second down. Back to throw again. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A big play that time on the catch and run. 33 yards. They're going to look to throw. He finds Smith and Jigba in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. A great effort there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead is now 21-14. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play,
he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Queen, and they will take over at the 26-yard line. But when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
This offense continues to be a hot knife through butter. 3 drives, 3 scores, and knocking on the door again on drive number 4. He finds Smith and Jigba in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. A great play there.
his way to a historic performance, 4 first half touchdowns. And the Seahawks are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Ravens' offense now, they get set and head back onto the field.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Defense is always talking about earning the right to rush the passer on 3rd down. And you know what offenses want? Win 1st down so they can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on 1st down. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Jackson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this 1st half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. To throw is Jackson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Ravens 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Yeah, these are the types of plays that we need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of 1st halves. This is a nice throw here on 3rd down, and they keep the drive going.
Jackson on 1st down. A short one there, caught by Likely. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Now a 2nd and 6. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
2 minutes remaining in this 1st half of football. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Jackson looking to throw on 3rd. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man to prove. And that wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 35. He's got his 1st catch here before halftime, and it goes for a 1st down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Dancing to his left. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard.
Well, we've seen Jackson already have success in the 1st half running the football, and he gets good yardage on the ground again there. I mean, how? I know it's a $64,000 question, CD, but how do they contain him better?
You have to win against the blockers ahead of you. If those guys even occupy a defender for even a half a second, then Lamar Jackson is gone. You got to take those blockers and move them so that you have clear vision of Lamar Jackson, and hopefully you can have him in.
The Raven passing game getting in sync, another 1st down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the 1st half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this 1st. And this is caught.
Touchdown, Baltimore. Nelson Aguilar. As the first half is winding down, and the Ravens are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. They're winning 17-28-21. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So we've reached halftime in a wild past the halfway point of the season and now past the halfway point of this game. We skip halftime and get right back to the action. Set to begin the third quarter. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jackson Smith and Jigba and his offense ready to go once more here. All right, how has he done it? Four touchdowns in this contest. He's been around the end zone in particular pretty much uncoverable.
And you know that I typically take things from a defensive perspective. I'm not going to do that this time. Let's just praise him. My goodness, four receiving touchdowns means he's beaten a variety of coverages throughout this game because they're not just letting him run scot-free. They're trying their best to shut him down, and he's shredding them.
I got to be honest, I want to see five. No, you want to see five? I mean, we're not supposed to be biased, but
we're not rooting. Just in the interest of the game, let's go ahead and see five.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Now this throw caught left side, and they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one good for 26 and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Now they'll try and set up the quarterback draw here. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Trenton Simpson firing in and sticking him for a loss. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. The throw over the middle taken in. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Well, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted. But it winds up falling incomplete. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They'll run for it. It's Walker. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. 2 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
He'll drop to throw. Going right back to Smith and Jigba. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. A big play there on the catch and run. And it'll move the chains. They'll set up a throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
On the slant, here's Smith and Jigba. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. Again, he'll drop to throw. to the goal line, but it's incomplete. It's been a long drive. They held it off for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. They had the play call on fourth and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And the Ravens come up big down at their own goal line. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2 yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 2 yard line.
Hey, middle, middle, middle.
Jackson going to give this one to Edwards. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Now it's Jackson. He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Bateman, he'll go in motion right here. He's going to handle it on the touch pass. Oh, this one, he may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Now Jackson, over the middle to Beckham. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line. Here now, third and a yard. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll punt it away for the second time. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating.
Back now in Baltimore. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. Now a throw here, hauled in. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Out right to Smith and Jigba. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Colby Parkinson from 10 yards out. And the Seahawks add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Ravens offense back out there. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. A short throw caught by Andrews. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. From the gun, it's Jackson. And his throw is incomplete.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
The Ravens on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and nine. Flush to his right. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there, because to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He'll check this down to Dobbins out of the backfield. He showed off the athletic juke, but it didn't buy him a whole lot of real estate. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that's going to bring up second down. Here's Jackson to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Jackson, draw play to Dobbins. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
Brandon, this can be so demoralizing for a defense. They've had 2 opportunities to get off the field. They haven't gotten it done. So now your coordinator, he's going to call every blitz that he has, any type of exotic, something that they haven't seen before. And he's also telling the defensive lineman, don't worry about holding people up. Just get in gaps and try and make a big play.
And not only not getting off the field on 2 opportunities, clock continuing to run. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Jackson being chased out left. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for 3rd. And they're going to speed things up here. From the gun on 3rd down, Jackson. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Suddenly looked like maybe his 3rd or his 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Here we go. It's Jackson on 4th down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. John Harbaugh, not afraid to go for it this time, doesn't work out. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that, because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, the team with the ball, guess what? Going to 4-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
The passing game continues to be their friend, even with a stable lead here in the 4th, Charles. They're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
Smith and Jigba hauling it in on the out route. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Trenton Simpson brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career. He's got Smith and Jigba. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And this will be caught by Metcalf for a Seahawk touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Seahawks are poised to move to 8-0 as they extend their lead even further.
Well, business as usual for them, well on their way to another victory, riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
The Seahawks offense staying put out on the field. They're going to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. He's got his man, it's Andrews. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Now they got to get to the line quickly. From midfield now, here's Jackson. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Jackson on first down. Pass on the crossing route is complete. This is Andrews. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And he'll go right back to Andrews. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
Here's a second and 5.
Now it's Jackson. And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Ravens have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Tucker with the extra point. And they're able to cut this deficit down to 12. So 2 scores down. Time definitely not an ally. But here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be taken in by the Seahawks. And it would appear they're on their way to victory now. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And complete to Smith and Jigba. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game.
Here is third and 5.
They'll drop to throw. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
He's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield, because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
And this is caught and all the way in, touchdown. Jackson, Smith, and Jigba. 36 yards. And the Seahawks have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Myers connects on the PAT, and that will make this a 19-point game. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. And the Ravens taking the field. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And whistles, and they take their final timeout with 7 seconds left. Now Jackson on first down. One last shot at the end zone. And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time has run out now on this game.
Well, this was a fun one today if you like points. A lot of them went on the board. Both offenses were clicking. Charles, these defenses, meanwhile, have a little something to clean up before their next contest.
Yeah, neither end zone had a stop sign in it, did they? I mean, for both sides, visit it, and with frequency. Not fun to be a defensive player, but on the offense.